Nora does the best work for folks here. We need doctors more than most anything else.
What? Hey, get away from my stew!
Oh, it's you.
What? No, of course not. Never seen you before in my life. I just figure you're you. You know? And I'm me, and that's where we are. So, what can old Mudtooth do for you, huh? This old mudder might have an answer or two for you. Quite a bit, stranger. The name's Mudtooth. And ain't nobody been around longer or seen more than I have. Except maybe old Ford, of course. But that old mudder cheats. Anyway, he hardly tells any of his stories. Only three reasons why folks come to see me. And that's my stories or my stew. Yeah. So, young'un, what'll it be? That so? Huh. Did I tell you about the stories yet? Right. So, let me see here. Folks come see me for my stories and my stew and... Listen, you sure I said there were three reasons? 'Cause there's only two, and that's certain. Huh. Only two reasons folks come to see old Mudtooth, and you know both of them. I'm pretty sure your memory's slipping. You bet your apple I can, but these ain't just stories, stranger. They're objective retellings of legitimate occurrences what you wouldn't believe. Now, where to start? I ever tell you how the world fell in the first place? Well... Sit down, friend, 'cause there ain't no one knows what really happened but me. It started in them wards, see? Secret military industrial complexes and whatnot. That's where they made all their weapons and did their experiments. Now, the root weren't meant to reproduce, see? They was built as a weapon, but then they done breeded and got out. Well, we all know what happened after that. Only reason the Root stopped was 'cause the Wanderer, well, he flamethrower-sized their queen, see? Over in that tower on the atoll, so's they couldn't breed no more. Now, listen. You might hear Ford tell you something different, but you look at the two of us and ask which has obviously been around longer. Which of us is most like to have been there, huh? You ask yourself that, and then you just look my way, because that's who it is. That's too bad. Stew is looking good, and smelling even better. Take care, young'un. Don't be a stranger.
Glad that's over. Maybe I should check out that mural again. This isn't looking good. Is it over? Bags full.
You're Eh, won't fit. Can't carry anymore. Nah, no room for that. Here they come. I've got enough of that. All right, let's do this. Won't fit. Seems like something is missing.
Welcome, mortal, to the court of Phaelin, benevolent and all-knowing. I am the slayer of the one true king and ruler of all Fae. Be glad, mortal, for few are given the pleasure of such a prize. You are not Fae, yet you do not bear the cheerless apathy of the drow. You are something new, I should wager. Yes? Tell us, stranger, what are you? What strange terms you bring to this court. I should like to learn more. Tell me, what is your purpose here? Clementine, I assume this friend is a creature like yourself. With that being the case, I fear I have only ill news for you. For you are quite unique in this realm. I feel terrible to think you came all this way for nothing. Perhaps I can provide some form of restitution. You have come quite a long way, have you not? And so, you must have great skill to have fought your way here. I could use someone of your ability. I am plagued by an imposter, one who claims my deeds and even my throne as his own. He calls himself Phaerin. Kill him, and I will see that your journey is not for nothing. Watch your tongue, mortal. I am Phaelin, the omnipotent, the true king of the Fae. That other is but an imposter, and this kingdom would only benefit from his death. You will find him in the shade, a twisted mockery of this glorious court, and a suitable metaphor for all the imposter stands for. Kill him. And you shall be greatly rewarded. Now, is there anything more we can do for you to speed you on your way? Very well, mortal. But only inasmuch as it will aid you in your service to me. He haunts me, mortal. Lives in my mind. Sees through my eyes, thinks with my thoughts. We cannot look away, cannot be alone. For we are not alone. For my Christ's sake, you must defeat me. Go to the Shade and end me once and for all. One and true are titles he placed upon himself. He spoke of freedom whilst his boot crushed our necks. He was never one of us and had no right to rule. The Fae should be ruled by the Fae, and so we freed ourselves. Freed all the Fae. Now, finally, there can be peace. You are strong and brave, mortal. But myopic. Peace takes time, and the firm hand of benevolence and wisdom. How can I provide that when the imposter hounds me so? Don't be absurd. It is Faerun you must kill. But be prepared, for we will not be easy to defeat. Not as such, but he will not wake from his slumber. And the thrones now belong to us. Throne. Singular. The throne is mine. We succeeded where others failed. And in so doing, we will bring order to chaos. You will know it when you see it. It is both like and unlike these glorious halls. A twisted mockery of all that I am, as is everything I do. He does. Faerun. It is Faerun who mocks us, who mocks me. End him for me, and you will have your reward. Excellent. Return once the deed is done, won't you? Remember, mortal, you will find me in the Shade. For you stand in the presence of Faerun, the Almighty. We are the slayer of the one true king, conqueror of all we survey. In my presence, all must tremble and fall. But you, aren't you a strange and pathetic little creature? I'm afraid you have stumbled into the wrong door. Little mouse. Yet, curiosity stays my hand a moment. What are you? Some sort of misshapen vermin? These words mean nothing to me. My curiosity wanes. Do you have purpose here? Or shall I crush you for want of entertainment? Is that another rodent like yourself? Unfortunately, little mouse, despite all that has happened to this world, I can assure you there are none like you in it. How pathetic to have come all this way only for your search to end in failure. Perhaps it need not be in vain. For me, at least. For you have come a long way, and even a mouse could not have done so without some skill at fighting. Not the way things are now. There is one who plagues me, an imposter who claims my deeds and strength as his own. He calls himself Feylin. Kill him, and you will earn my esteem. That is no small thing, my mouse. You will find him in the golden halls, a gaudy mockery of my court, as everything about him is a mockery. Kill him, and you shall be greatly rewarded. Away now, mouse! Why do you still stand before me? And what makes you think you've earned the right to an audience? I grant it, but only to speed the death of the one who vexes me. It bores us then, and risks its life. Very well. Ask. Did I? That does sound like me. But we are lying to you, mouse. It is I whom you must defeat, not me. Are you considered intelligent among your kind? It is Feylin you must kill. We are the imposter who vexes us. We are nothing alike. He sets himself up as a mockery of my glory, that is all. Kill us, and you will see. He haunts me, mouse. He lives in my mind. He sees with my eyes. We cannot look away, cannot be alone. For we are not alone. You must defeat me. You'll find me in the Golden Halls. Go there and end me. You are a fool, little mouse, if you think you can defeat me. No, Feylin resides in the Golden Halls, and we will not be easy to kill. But kill us you must, else we will end you. Finally, kill Feylin mouse, but beware, I will not be an easy opponent. Do not come back with the deed undone. Do you bring news, mortal? Oh, you would choose death as your reward, then? Very well, mortal. I will grant it to you. Come, and see the firm hand of benevolence. Okay.
Starting to think Clementine isn't here. So, what now? Guess I'll just find the nearest world stone.
The mouse has served its purpose. The haunting presence evaporated, and I am alone again, myself. So I won't kill you today, little mouse, but I will uphold my part of the bargain. Now go. My patience can only be renewed so much. This is not a vermin court. Be gone.